If you add an Y at the end of boot, it's booty. And that means the treasure inside the trunk.
There is some coins here. And if you have lots of coins, then you have a big booty. And then sometimes people say, shake that booty. And then you shake the booty. That's it. You shake it. And some people don't have a treasure, they just have junk in the trunk.
Our next guest is known as the most popular comedian in his home country of Finland and won the title of funniest person in the world in 2014. Please welcome Ismo!
Before the break I said Metulun Metukaisen. And you're like, no. What was I really trying to say?
So you were saying Metule Metakaisen, which means we'll be back.
Okay, Metule Metakaisen.
Yeah, Finnish is pronounced completely differently.
Yes, it is. I would say Metule Metakaisen with a Texas accent. That's what happened right there.
Yeah.
All right, let's go back to a little bit of Finland. It's one of those countries that's I think most of us aren't quite sure about Finland, right? It's a small country.
Yeah, small. Yeah.
Yeah, so basically as many people as, not so much bigger than Houston, actually.
Yeah, it's 5 million in Finland total who speak the language, which is such a weird language. It's like, it's not related to basically almost any other language. And it's really, really different. Like every language mother begins with M, like it's like mama or madre or something. But in Finland, mother is äiti. And that's still the first words we learned.
So there were like a couple of, like, so last, like a couple weekends ago, it was like, aiti day.
Yeah.
Oh, okay, did I say it right? Aiti.
Yeah, aiti.
Aiti.
We don't have to stretch it that long.
Oh, okay, that's called the Texas drawl. That's what happened right there.
Oh, yeah.
Like, okay, so you were a former commander of a military unit, because all men must serve in Finland.
Well, that sounds so fancy when you say it like that. But yeah, so, but it's like in Finland, everybody has to go to the army to just like be there for like 6 months, and I was actually there for 12 months, so basically technically I'm a squad leader. If somebody attacks Finland, I hope they don't, because like
you'll kill them with laughter.
Like I wouldn't be prepared at all, so.
But you did study physics in college.
I did.
When was the decision to say physics or comedy? Physics or left side or right side of the brain?
Yeah, it's like my comedy, actually, I try to, like, I think I try to analyze things, like language and other things. I try to be logical, so I think it's kind of, it's somewhere there, the physics, somehow.
Somehow, yeah, but, it's analytical, and when it comes to, like, a foreign language, that has to be somewhat analytical.
Yeah.
Okay, Finland is also known as the world's happiest country.
Well, that's the, everybody in Finland were, like, devastated to hear that, like, I think everybody in Finland, when they heard that news in global news that Finland is now the happiest country, I think everybody was like, so am I the only one who is not happy?
In Finland, yes. Okay. It's a great place for the Northern Lights. If you're looking at vacation for that, you have 187,888 lakes.
Yeah,
Did you know that?
I think I have swam in all of them.
you have more saunas than cars. What's up with that?
Well, we like to be warm. Like in here you don't need, in Houston you don't need sauna, it's sauna outside.
And this might make a lot of people move to Finland. Free education, PhDs earn top hat and a sword.
Yeah, that's actually my friend just from physics, he actually graduated to a PhD. I was doing gigs by then. But so yeah, he got a sword. It's kind of in the military, we don't have swords anymore, but with doctors.
But PhDs, you do. Yes. Okay. And you also have some kind of interesting, like, you know, here in America, it's like, you know, football, basketball, baseball, you know, it's kind of our thing, soccer, a whole bit. Wife carrying championships.
Yeah, that's a sport in Finland. Yeah,
you just carry your wife.
And like, there's like a big, like, a track around the forest, and you have to go through things and obstacles and. So, with your wife, somewhere. There's different techniques how to carry it.
I want to see this, actually. Yeah. Okay, and this is where Finland and Houston, we could be your sister city, because you have mosquito hunting competitions.
Oh,
but you don't have to hunt very hard here in Houston, though.
It's just like who gets it the most. And it sounds like people are applauding.
Okay. Yeah. All right. Funniest person in the world. So, you know, to get up on stage and actually do a stand-up comedy routine, especially in another country, was that nerve-wracking for you?
Well, yeah, like I kind of had to start from scratch, which is a funny sentence. Like, why would I start from scratch?
Right, right, because literally, yeah, exactly. Therein lies where a lot of your comedy is based on, is the English language from your point of view. Okay, you were on Conan, and that went viral, over 70 million views in 3 days.
Yay.
And so you break down the English language. We want to kind of break down a few of your words. There's one, I don't even know how to, I don't know what I'm saying here, but it's like, this word right here.
Okay, that's hyppytynytynyty.
Yes.
It's like, has like 10 letter Y's. And Y, to, when we see Y, we pronounce
I'd like to buy a vowel.
It's like So it's just three words put together that are only
Yes, okay. It means bouncy cushion satisfaction.
Yeah, it makes no sense, but it has lots of oohs there.
Yeah. And I had said Yanni Shalsu earlier, which you said meant rabbit pants. Well, in America, it's kind of like scaredy cat or scaredy pants.
Yeah, we have rabbits in our pants for some reason.
You have rabbits in your pants for some reason. Yeah. Okay. Poron kusema.
Yeah, we roll R, so it's poron.
Oh, poron. Poron kusama.
Poron kusema, yes. That's reindeer peeing. And it's a measure of distance. You can say, like, how far is that city? Oh, it's like three reindeer peeing. So that's
because it's how long it takes for the reindeer to have to pee.
Yeah, if like reindeer walks in the forest, like it stops for a pee and then stops again, and that's the distance between the two pees. That's why it's not very specific.
Yeah, in case y'all were wondering, it's 4.7 miles. Yes. Okay. And so, and you really have reindeer there?
Yeah, we have tons of reindeer.
Oh, that's really awesome. Yeah, okay, so that's where they stay in the off season.
Yeah.
We'll get at home. No. Okay. Joulupukki.
That's Christmas. And yeah, Pukki, that's goat, like a male goat.
So Christmas goat.
Yeah.
Well, so we had the reindeer, I understand them, but there's a Christmas goat too?
Yeah. And that's Santa Claus.
Oh, Santa Claus is called Christmas goat because he kind of looks like a goat with a beard.
I don't know why it's called that, but that's how we say Santa Claus.
Okay. And then there's other things happening in Finland that I think we need to have an investigation. What is that?
Kalsari kännit.
Yes, which means getting drunk at home in your underwear.
Yeah, and we could add with no intention to go out.
Okay, all right, and there are a couple of more here that, and the longest word in the language is this one right here.
Okay, so lentokone suihkuturbiini apumekaanikko aliupseeri oppilas. That's like one word. There's no spaces there. So, but it's
it's an airplane jet turbine engine auxiliary mechanic non-commissioned officer student.
There's no spaces. When we just combine it all to one word, basically. Yeah. So it's a long
word. Okay, well, I am so glad that you're in Houston and we can just like bring these two cultures together.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you so much. I'm gonna teach you how to say stuff in a Texas that say thank you, y'all.
Thank you, y'all.
Okay, almost. Hey. Ismo is performing at the Joke Joint Comedy Club, tonight and tomorrow night at 8 and 10:30 and Sunday at 8 p.m. Tickets start at just $14 and are available online. For more information, log on to greatdayhouston.com. How do I say thank you in Finnish?
Kiitos.
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 Kiitos. All right, there you go.
Thank you.